Hey you guys, I'm going to share with you a little recipe reveal for kids in the kitchen or tweens. It's a crock pot recipe, and I always think of crock pot ideas as the weather gets warmer because it's so much easier and keeps your house cooler to make your food in a crock pot. So what I did was I have cranked up the crock pot. Get your pen and paper. I might have to do this in two or three sections, different videos together. But from Vaughn's we had this roast. It was a prime rib roast. And I covered the bottom of the crock pot with Italian salad dressing. That is such a good marinade because it has tons of herbs and spices in it. So, and then put the rib roast in there and let it cook till that was done. And so it's been cooling for a few hours. Then I left the juice in there. Filled it with water, and these are those like top ramen noodles. Put about 5 or 6, maybe 7 packages of noodles, added water. So when they came out, they have a little bit of a taste to them. The beef juice that was in there has given a little bit of taste to the noodles. But the house isn't all steamed up from cooking all those noodles over the stove. So right now I'm going to do a little prepping with the roast and the noodles. And I'll be right back. Okay, so what I've done here, I took that rib roast, sliced it up, and I have little pieces. And took some noodles. Here it's chopped up and cut up in real small pieces so you could eat this with a spoon, and just noodles in those dish, but in those dishes. But yeah, get your pen and paper, and really the idea behind this was our kids in mind. For two reasons. I have a niece gonna be 3, and the problems my sister's having with her getting good nutrition because she's so finicky and picky, and then a friend of the family on medication, a 9-year-old boy, with the ADD stuff and all these medications that for some reason cause him not to eat. Or moodiness. I'm not sure what it is. So, though I do call this a recipe reveal, it's kind of like nothing new. You know, we've all cooked in a crock pot. But it's just a different way to do things with our kids in mind and such that it'd be fun for them and we can get them to eat. And they don't even know they're eating. And the one friend of the family, the boy, he will eat. If you go out to breakfast or to a restaurant, he will eat more than if he's just at home. So it made me think, you know, is it something in what we're doing or not doing that is making our food visibly appealing to our kids? So I pulled out, looking at my little antique Betty Crocker cookbook from 1954, something my mom just gave me. But listen to this. Betty Crocker writes a note. Dear friend, 3 times a day and sometimes more, every homemaker asks herself what I can serve that my family and friends will enjoy. To help make the answer easier for you, we have divided this book into four sections: breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks, between meals being the fourth meal. A glance through any section will suggest many delicious possibilities, good foods, easy to prepare, and we hope they will make mealtimes happy in your home. Happy times in your home. Sincerely, Betty Crocker. P.S. Every recipe in this book has been carefully tested for you. How cute. So, I have three pages that kind of caught my eye. It says, pretty breakfast. It says, breakfast should always be an attractive meal, both for the family and for guests. So I'm sure back in 1954, that was very attractive. So I thought of our little kids who, you know, it's very unsettling to know that our kids are not getting good nutrition for whatever reason, whatever, if they have bad choices or they're fussy eaters. So I thought that maybe that's something we need to do. We need to make it fun looking for our kids. Then, over here, look, this reminds me of the Wonder Bread. Look, everybody ate white bread. Now, this is unusual. 1954, they had like a wheat bread there. Honestly, as a kid, I think all we ever ate was Wonder Bread. I never knew there was like a wheat bread. Wonder Bread and French bread, because we're half Italian. So, but look at the plates. Look at how everything matches. Salt and pepper shaker and this bread thing and all that. And it made me think, oh, wait, we can make it more fun for kids. How we, and the things we use to serve our food. And then this just kind of brought the point home for me that, see how this is all matching? You know, as grown-ups, we're going to eat what we're going to eat. But this recipe reveal is pretty much with fussy eater kids in mind. And so I want you to think that I'm creating this whole new recipe that isn't, you guys have never done before, because I'm sure you have. But what I'm trying to just help us do in this video is cooking with a crock pot that doesn't heat up your house. That's a big deal for some of us people. We don't want to cook in the oven or boil a ton of stuff on the stove. A crock pot is nice because it doesn't heat up your house. Normally people wouldn't think of cooking top ramen noodles in a crock pot, but it works. So anyways, I'm going to bring out more of my little food items. So keep in mind your child, and as I'm going through this, this is by just cooking in the crock pot, the rib roast and the noodles, it becomes like a soup and a salad bar. Yeah, that the kids can choose. Do they want to make their noodles and their other food items into a soup or into a salad? So let me rearrange some of the food items here and explain a little more. Okay, but kind of first, real quick, what I just want to make mention of is fun utensils and fun plates and spoons and dishes for our kids. These are plastic. I got them from Amazon. Matching cups, knife, fork, spoons, and bowls and dishes. Straws. I think my daughter felt like at Party City. So put this on your pen and paper. Really put your thinking cap on. Figure out what is your child, what's their color, what's their thing. And I think you can get these cheap bandanas from Dollar Tree. I got mine from Amazon. And put two in a napkin ring. So when they undo it, they have two. And if it's a little girl, they can tie it up and tie their hair up so they have like a matching hair tie with their napkin. If it's a boy, they can wind it up real tight and they can put it in their belt, make like a little belt loop or have it hanging out of their pocket, though I don't know, you know, what might be appropriate for boys. But again, put your thinking cap on and oh, here's something else cute. You know, sometimes if our kids won't eat healthy food, maybe we can get them to drink healthy food. Here's another cute little cup idea. My little niece, she'll drink anything out of these little cups. So I've been able to switch her from unhealthy Gatorade to this little sparkling apple cider. It's not the best, but it's more healthy than the Gatorade. So just by changing the cup, and you can get these little apple cider, sparkling ciders from Dollar Tree. So that works. And the other thing is my sister was saying the words big and strong, big and strong. And one day my niece came over and she was eating a huge bowl of vegetables. She says, because I want to be a dancer, I need to be big and strong. So I think if we remember to remind our kids, like, what is it they like? If they want to be a construction worker or a ballet dancer or an artist or a florist or a gardener, big and strong, big and strong. And we can incorporate what foods will help you attain what you want to be when you grow up, and you want to be healthy and strong and grow up feeling well so you can do the job you want to do. I was amazed. So that was something I learned. And, you know, whatever the colors are that just bring your, brighten up your kids' day, you have to think of that. Dollar Tree has so many fun things, napkins, everything from A to Z. So you want to have all that kind of prepared for them as you're bringing the food out. Okay, so real quick, I just did this in a small little scale so we could get it in the camera, but what you would want to do is find some nice glass bowls. It would be like a soup bar and a salad bar. Again, we're going to use the noodles to either make like a pasta salad or soup. But if you could find glass bowls or whatever kind of fun bowls that would make your kids happy. So you have all these bowls out on the counter. Here, or you might want to write these down, some choices. Pumpkin seeds. Pepperoni. My little niece goes crazy over pepperoni, so she wouldn't want to put the meat on, but she'd fill her little salad or soup with pepperoni. Hard-boiled egg. Cut up some hard-boiled egg. Kids might be crazy about hard-boiled egg. It's healthy. And of course, scallions chopped up. And I like to use the green little stalks for like decoration in a salad or even a soup. And some other healthy little items are little baby shrimp, salad shrimps, little Brussels sprouts. And I get these frozen, the bell peppers, red, green, yellow, and orange bell peppers. Healthy and kind of different, kind of fun. And other ideas are that they could top their pasta salad or soup with Parmesan cheese, grated cheese. I just had these cheese slices, but you could grate cheese, you know, in the real fine little cheese grater, and they might want to put it on top of their soup or salad. Corn, kids go crazy about corn. You can have a little dish of corn, little dish of green olives. Just the color contrast might ignite their imagination and they might eat it. A little bowl of black olives. And for the soup, these are the packets that came with the top ramen. So boiled water got the soup, the little broth going. And it might be fun if you had like a ladle, like you made the broth in a big bowl and with a ladle, so they could really scoop their own broth into their soup. And then seasonings and little toppings. You can set some soy sauce out on the counter. Ketchup or mustard, and the kids can flip this over and pour, draw like a happy face on the top of their salad or their noodles, or you can use ketchup or mustard, and of course salt and pepper. And look, you can put little sprinkles. They might sprinkle a couple little sprinkles on top of their noodles and eat the whole bowl. Little celery. And cumin is a healthier, cumin is just a healthier version of the taco mix package. It smells just like tacos, so you might want to, I don't know how you would mix it in with your noodles or make a taco base for the soup. It's just some ideas. Kids love tacos, and if they get a whiff of the tacos, they may eat their and their noodles. So just some more ideas for you. So now, after all is said and done, you can see I made for myself like a salad. And this was like radicchio, and these were basil, and I had some chopped up cabbage, purple cabbage. Well, I made a salad with the noodles underneath, and it was like a pasta meat salad. And here's this little soup. And you can get these Chinese spoons and bowls from Amazon. But I chopped up the noodles. And look, there's shrimp, scallions, peas. So who knows what your child's going to put together. And here's a childlike little salad with just all this stuff kind of globbed on, and maybe for a topping they'll put on some cheese. But anyways, the idea is to just get your child motivated to get food. There's so many things going on that just make for our kids to not have a good daily diet of healthy food. So hopefully this helps. And the other thing, I will make a link below to J. Rob Egg White Protein Powder. It tastes just like chocolate milk. Of course, ask your doctor if it's okay to give your child this protein mix. But it's just like chocolate milk. If you had your little cup, your fun little cup, if you had your fun little cup and filled this with the J. Rob Protein Powder, it would be just something to think about. Anyways, thanks.